In the previous section, we saw that the energy of the universe is a constant. Energy can only be transferred, not created or destroyed. Some parts of the universe gain it and others lose it. But when it's all added up, the gains and losses cancel themselves out and the energy change for the universe is zero. So looking at the energy of the universe to decide whether something will occur or not is not very useful, as we know it will not budge. So what determines if a process will occur or not? Though we intuitively know that some things will happen and other things will never happen, how does the universe figure out if something is going to occur? It ends up that another fundamental thermodynamic quantity exists, entropy. Entropy is formally defined as heat divided by the temperature, thus possessing the units of joules per Kelvin. But we may qualitatively define entropy as disorder. Low entropy corresponds to order, and high entropy corresponds to disorder. What we have discovered is that the universe loves disorder. In other words, the universe hates order. The second law of thermodynamics states that the entropy of the universe increases for any spontaneous process. Another way of looking at it is that if you find that a process will lead to a lowering of the entropy of the universe, or a lowering of the disorder in the universe, then you know that the process is not going to happen. And finally, if we have equilibrium and nothing is occurring, then the entropy of the universe remains the same. It can increase, it can remain the same, but the entropy of the universe will never decrease. Note that the second law of thermodynamics applies to the universe. Yes, if you put water in a freezer, its disorder will diminish when it goes from liquid water to solid ice. The entropy of the water is diminished. But the water is not the whole universe, and we must also consider the surrounding environment. The freezing will not happen without the electricity required to run the freezer. Also, the freezer is generating heat and causing the molecules of the surrounding air to move faster, thus creating more disorder. When we take into account the disorder created to generate the electricity and the disorder created by the heat given off by the freezer, the entropy of the universe does indeed increase. We can do the calculations to confirm that the entropy of the universe has indeed increased, or we can simply reassure ourselves that the second law of thermodynamics is guaranteeing that this is going to happen.